Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
He's a fabulous actor. We just have fun because, you know, he's the kind who comes, even after giving a fantabulous shot, he's the kind who will come and say, I should have done this and, you know, I should have done that. And so now, and I'm the kind who's giving an average shot and saying, I did so well today.
She's superlative and she's more talented than me, but she chooses to sit at home and take care of both kids. And I'm able to go out and I'm able to do films and, you know, come back home. And her 4-5 projects
are waiting. My God, he's going to get so many more female fan following now, which is more of a stress for me now.
Jyothika and Surya, I am so thrilled to have the power couple of Tamil cinema on Film Companion. Thank you for making the time.
Thank you for this time.
You know, I was just thinking, this must be such an exciting time for you, right? Jyothika, you've just had a release, Udan Pirape. Please forgive me if I've totally mangled that name. I'm hoping I got it right. And Surya, you of course have Jai Bheem coming. What is the house like right now? Is there nervous tension or are you two just veterans and you've seen too many Fridays now?
No, still excited with each and every project. We still have those, we get nervous and a lot of feedbacks, a lot of calls, all that is happening. So yes, the same excitement as whatever happened 24 years back, it's still there.
So jitters and all fully.
Yeah, actually each time, I think in this stage of your career, each time you're experimenting and trying something new. So it feels more tension and how people are going to receive it and what are they expecting out of you now. So it's in layers. There's a lot of tension with every release. We're still learning.
You know, actually, I've been wanting to do this interview since I read, in fact, in Variety magazine, the sort of Hollywood trade magazine, about the 4-film deal that your production house, 2D Entertainment, signed with Amazon. And 2D was really one of the early adopters of streaming. At a time when we didn't know how this would all pan out, you guys said, no, we're going ahead with this. And now that the world seems to be, I don't want to jinx it, I'm hoping that it'll all go well, but now that the world seems to be sort of, you know, reopening up, what are you seeing in, like, let's say even the next 6 months? Are you going to do some films just for streaming, some films just for theater? What is your thinking right now about this?
So we are just, I think, going with the flow. And right now, the flow seems very beautiful when there is a mix of everything. We do need the theaters, definitely. And we, likewise, we need the OTT too. So I think we're all on, the same side of the page. And we all need to flow together. So I guess it has to be hand in hand. And it's beautiful when it's that way. We also have so many films churning out in a year that it's nice that when, you know, the smaller films don't get a flow to the theater, they have an optional platform for release. So we are seeing having a companionship with both the streams, which seem to be one stream on one side of the page, actually. So,
but would you, as producers, design films that would specifically be for streaming?
I think so. So the next few films what I've signed are huge theatrical releases. And they need that 800 plus screens to get back what we invested and the time and effort was going to be put in those films. But not necessarily every film should have those 1,000 screens or 1,500 screens. Please is what I genuinely think. And you cannot always have a clear Friday, a clear weekend for your movies. You're going to be the films. There are a lot of contents which are very niche, which are very, very special and which are very close to us. And I think this is a wonderful platform we have got to connect to 200 plus countries and fantastic audience. And we don't have to compromise on anything, be it the footage. It can be an hour and a half film also. It can be lesser than hour and a half also. And it need not have the regular movie making elements of song, dance, and a lot of other stuff. We can just go to that core emotion and tell only that story.
Yeah.
You don't have to artificially implant so many other things. And it's beautiful to make such films, which are very, very close to heart. And you just want to tell certain things which might not have happened if this OTT platform was not available for all of us.
Yeah, it's an exciting time.
Correct. So definitely a lot of excitement and a lot of opportunities. In fact, last week we sat and we had like 15 plus ideas and stories which we think can beautifully happen on either side, like theater and simultaneously on an OTT platform. We thought like this can beautifully evolve and beautifully can have one nice parallel journey.
That's amazing. And but tell me, when the two of you, like you say, discuss 15 story ideas, so who's the final authority at 2D? Who gets to have the final say that we're doing this and not doing that?
Yeah.
It's both ways. I decide my films, he and both of us decide his.
I admire her clarity in thoughts. So I just go by that. I just wait for that one drop to come. No, what is that? No final word she gives, and I like it. So we wait for that one word from her.
So it's all you, Jyotika. You're the boss.
No, it's not me. It's just the newness of a thought. That's it. And I think 2D gets attracted to that. We also love new talent and people who are coming up with stories out of the box, one-liners which haven't been made as yet. And we're just trying our own way, to experiment different kind of small one-liner films which work in a big way.
So like Surya Potra, I knew this was a different attempt. Surya Potra, I thought it was special, but she said like, don't even think, just go, take it. No, this you don't get it. So she was more, bang on that idea. And
so you had a little hesitation about the film?
Not hesitation at all, but we knew that process is going to happen. And yes, we have to invest a lot of love. And this is going to be a beautiful journey. It's going to be a very different film from what I've done before. So all those ifs and buts and questions, what all should happen around it? That we usually build up, how to make this more engaging, more interesting. And yes, it's going to be a new world. But she said, this is going to be something else. That was that one line which she was able to completely say, you plan your own things, you do all things and worry about so many other stuff, but this is going to be something else. That gut feeling, this is going to be something else, is immediately picking on something that very naturally and very casually happens with her.
Well, you bang on, because it was something else. It's such a wonderful film. So, what's interesting to me is that in some of the key films, the milestone films in your career, like, the Singham series or Kaka, you're playing characters who are very much part of the establishment. You're playing cops. And in fact, you've said in interviews that cops have told you that they became cops after seeing those movies. That's how effective those characters were. But with Jai Bhim, you're very much against the establishment. Is this part of your process also personally, because this film agrees with your politics? Have your politics changed, or was it just a script that you really loved?
So many things happen around us. You hear about so many things around you. Sometimes one question will come and hit you hard. What are you doing about it? So Jai Bhim is one such question, and we are trying to answer that. It's 80 kilometers away from my place, my house, from heart of the city, just not even 80 kilometers away. And there is a huge community still living without a ration card, without electricity, without community certificate. And they're not allowed to sometimes get into a bus, and they're not allowed to get into their village. And they're not allowed to wear chapels. And they're, even if they are old, as 80 years old, here they say Vada Podi. So they are called Vada Podi only, even if they are 80 year old. So somewhere, I think it's always nice if we know our past, our future will be even better. We both are inspired by true stories, true instances. And this was a fantastic thing came our way. And that's why Jai Bhim, and that's why Chandru, and that's why Advocate and not the cop.
You're both also, I think, very concerned with the messaging in movies, right? Jyotika, you've talked in your interviews about how when women especially leave your films, you want them to feel respected. But, movies are also about storytelling. And there has been some criticism, especially Jyotika, about some of your films, that the messaging overpowers the storytelling. How do you two try and balance that? Because you both said that the messaging of a film now is very important to two of you.
Right. So a story is always the hero of the, it's always in the focus. So a film is picked because the story is good. And according to me, films are a mere reflection of what's happening in real life. So each and every film, including Udan Piripur, my last film, is a true story that is a reflection of how people are. And I personally feel that we are at a stage where we influence a lot of a common man because we do have an impact on them. So when you feel there is something like, you know, in something in villages which is traditionally still followed, which sort of needs to be set right, or you want to give your opinion on certain things which can be, you know, correct. I think it's not no harm in saying it through films. You know, and I also feel it's very different. I mean, you're watching 90 films which are not giving a message. So why do you want to watch 91? I mean, you know, there is something good to say. We're not opposing anything. We're just saying things we want to say right to the audience. That's it. So for me, yeah, the message does matter. Very frankly saying, it does matter because there are a lot of good things to be said and followed.
And definitely, those are not our handwritten dialogues. Those are written by the directors and whatever we are connected with and convinced with, of course, we don't say
yeah,
that.
Like, for example, in Udan Piripur, we had said that, you know, in villages, you know, for the heir of the family, the men are remarried, you know, when they don't have an inheritor. So the men are remarried. So why not the women? So we have questioned things like this, which seem to be, which look like a message, but actually you're just trying to set things right. You know, you're like, yeah, why? Many people are not aware that a boy or a girl baby is the responsibility of a man and not a woman, you know? So I feel these are the things you can educate in a film in a very subtle way. And why not? It's no harm. It only does good. So
Of course. But do you struggle to keep that balance between the correct messaging and the sort of, you know, the drama aspect, the storytelling aspect of it?
Yeah, it is. There's no struggle, actually. I think it all falls in place. If you're saying the right thing, it just falls into the script by itself.
It's the perspective which age group is saying that. You know?
Yeah.
Sometimes Udan Piripur film, the 16-year-old or 15-year-old might not connect with it. The 30-plus will connect with, you know, with the power of silence. Sometimes what most of the women do at home, and the silence sometimes bonds the family and they choose to be silent. So that a 12-year-old or a 13-year-old might not understand. But we have so many feedbacks, so many people when we walk, jog, travel, everybody's saying like, this is one of your best films. So there is also this perspective which comes our way. And it's about how many people you're able to connect with and how many people you're able to satisfy. And definitely we have a little judgment of, you know, what is happening. We definitely immediately accept what is right and what is wrong, you know, whenever there is a positive criticism. And definitely, I don't think there is a struggle to entertain, and also definitely we don't teach. I think we let them ponder.
You're just giving thoughts. You're just putting thoughts out there. Something to think about.
I genuinely think so.
You know, Surya, you said in an interview that silence is the worst form of violence, right? But for actors now, especially in the Hindi film industry, speaking out, especially in the current climate, has become very risky. Now, the two of you have spoken your mind. You've put out your opinions. You've also generated controversy. What has that done? Has that made you feel that perhaps not, let's just stick to acting and putting our messaging in the stories? Or does it make you sort of even firmer in your resolve that we need to say what we believe?
I think we need to say what we believe.
Yeah. And as long as you're saying the right thing, I think you get good sleep and you feel very content. And I personally feel that, you know, when God has placed you in a position where you influence minds largely, why not, make it worth it, actually? Why not, you know, come out there and say something which will make a little difference and make a better world or make people think positively. So yeah, we do believe that saying it works.
We have a lot of love for a fellow human being. We have a lot of love and we are thankful to the society we are in. And definitely we believe we are very, very blessed with whatever we have, you know, got now after 20, 25 years. And when saying something, like, for example, I don't know if I should take this topic again. She had something to voice out for a government hospital next to a temple.
Yeah.
And definitely, you know, a lot of reactions happened. But in a month's time, the government authorities also realized and they tried to clear the space and they found some 10 plus venomous snakes in the compound, in the hospital compound. And the government also came forward to renovate the whole hospital where 20 plus villages, almost 30 villages were benefiting out of the hospital. And the hospital is looking like a very new building right now. And there are like 1,000 mothers using that hospital. So it's okay to get that bricks and stones and whatever, but something good happens in the end of the day.
Yeah.
And one film of us, Ponmagal Vandal, literally saved one 8-year-old, 9-year-old's life.
Yes, I read about it. Yeah.
So these things, they make us believe in good. And use your voice for whatever genuinely you're sensitive to. It hits your heart. We don't need publicity.
Anupama, you have to talk about Jai Bhim, otherwise this will be like my interview. He'll keep talking about me.
Okay, all right. Coming back to Jai Bhim, you know, what I found fascinating was that in the early days of the lockdown, Suri, you said that you actually watched videos on how to improve as an actor, which I found amazing because you've been an actor since the late 90s, okay? And you're still hungry to get better and you're watching masterclasses on how to act better. And you always say in all your interviews that Jyotika is in fact the better actor, which is also amazing. Now, how do you keep this hunger alive?
I don't know. I genuinely got scared. I felt very upset watching my films, previous 4 or 5 films where when I entered the dubbing theater, because that's the most, I don't see my rushes. I don't see the edited footage. So the first time I go and watch my work is at a dubbing theater on the screen. So I'm not happy with what I saw. I was not happy to start a dubbing. Something about that was very mundane, very boring. And I thought like, what am I doing? I keep talking about this to Madhur and I keep troubling her. I keep not telling this to everyone, but there was something which I want to break. I was getting bored with what I was doing. I definitely, there's a lot of schools, a lot of way of, you know, approaching a character and all that. But I think that whole atmosphere itself, I wanted a change. I wanted something to shake me and change. That happened with Sudha. I think, you know, she had watched all my films and she put all those clips and limitations. Don't do this, don't do that, let's do this. And that got me excited. It was like one fresh air for me after 24 years. Surarai Potru again gave me that excitement to be an actor, to be very active and be excited about each and every day and go to a shooting. So Sudha was a big help to look forward for good content, to go excited for a shooting day. I think all happened and Jai Bhim again continued. So Nyanavel is like a student reporter. I met him. And he is much, much younger to me. And also he's a person who helped me start Agram Foundation. So to suddenly see him from my office and like a close friend, suddenly directing me and asking me to act like this, start action, no, do this one more, I want one more and all that. It was a very new experience for me that 40 days. And he surpassed all the expectations as a storyteller, as a dialogue writer, as a screenplay thing, and getting performance from all the actors and preparing the actors for the stage. And I don't know how he got everything right. This is what I believe. I really enjoyed doing Jai Bhim, and Jai Bhim will be a very important film in my career. I'm not talking about whatever now. Now we don't have to worry about the box office success collection, but this will stay in most of our hearts for a very, very long time. So that's the kind of film I think we have made. And I'm happy that I am not holding back and I can just tell this frankly. I'm not making something which is failure, money earner or you know, something which will not for like, I always build up, you know, okay, let's have this one support system. Let's do this. Let's do that for a film. Now I've let go of all that. Now I'm, I think, trying to follow my heart more, a little more.
And Jyothika, how frank are you as his closest confidant and critic? When you are embarking on something like Jai Bheem, which for an actor is extremely demanding, can you watch a scene and say to him, no, this doesn't work?
Yeah, we're absolutely transparent with each other. And, I think we just see a film, or it's from the signing stage itself, actually, when we are commenting on each other's work. We agree, disagree. We also take our own paths. We also do what we both believe in. But yeah, that transparency has to be there between us. I mean, that's the stage one for the company also, what you're doing under the banner, it needs to have a good battle of opinion. So we're very transparent.
She's like the toughest professor in your college. You cannot get those marks. You cannot get those grace marks. You cannot impress this professor.
He's a fabulous actor. We just have fun because, he's the kind who comes, even after giving a fantabulous shot, he's the kind who will come and say, I should have done this and, I should have done that. And so now, and I'm the kind who's giving an average shot and saying, I did so well today, so it's like, it's fun. We just know, we work together so much.
She likes her first take. I like my last take. It can be my 17th take also, but I like my last take. She likes her first take.
Yeah,
so and she can...
Yeah, we are just opposites. And yeah, we're very transparent when it comes to work. Definitely. Now, he gets a bit scared to tell me if I'm bad, but I say it.
Why does he get scared? Do you not take criticism well?
No, it's a husband-wife thing.
No, the final argument will always be won by her. So we don't get into that. The final punchline is hers.
It's hers, correct, correct. So 2D, of course, also has your brother Karthi. He's part of the company. You are both, of course, sons of a very famous actor. This is something that really intrigues me as an outsider to the Tamil film industry, is that in the last few years in Bollywood, in the Mumbai film industry, there's been so much conversation about nepotism, right? And how it has stunted the film industry and what should be done about it. But in the South, that hasn't happened. Not in Telugu cinema, which is essentially run by very powerful film families. I haven't seen much of it in Tamil. Why do you think that is? What is the difference?
I think...
Yeah, go ahead. But I would like to say, I don't know if I'm right, wrong, but this is what happened. My dad has never met a single director or a single producer, gone to a production house or asked someone to come and tell a story or recommended me or given me an idea that go be an actor, choose this field. These conversations have never happened between us. And it was one day director Vasan sir came and said, can I choose him? Can I take him? Ask him. No, he's there in the other room. I was leaving for I was working in a garment export factory. So I said, 15 minutes, I have to be inside the gate. They might close the gate. Sorry, sir, can I meet you next week? And I just know that's what our lives were like that. Even if we had a shooting happening in the next street, we've never been there. So we've never been introduced to the film industry properly. And all of a sudden this happened. We had something at home happening. I took a chance after 3 years being in a garment industry. By chance, I became an actor. So dad never interfered. Even now, none of the scripts he's heard, even if a film is ready, he never watches in a preview show. He goes to the public and watches it with the public. He never...
Really?
Wow. And never interferes in a story or understands what we are doing. Even if you're producing nothing he comes into in our way. Even when I was failing, it's not like every film of mine was a success.
Yeah.
Find your own way is what he said. So he was never there to recommend or say okay, now it's a failure. Let me assemble a film for you. Get the best producer, get the best director. I'm going to save you. It never happened. So it's the industry and it's the people who, you know, took me through this journey. You know, even when we are falling, it was the fans who had large hearted to still love us and give us that little time to understand what I should be doing. And of course, they were very harsh and they were rejecting my films, straightforward, or whatever budgets they were and whatever those films were made with. So through this journey, I was handheld by the fans, by the society, and of course, by the directors who believed I can still deliver. A big thanks to Bala, my director Bala sir, who made me believe that I can be an actor. I was struggling for the first almost 8 films. I didn't know what I was doing, because straight from a garment swing industry, I just jumped and came and stood in front of the light and camera. I learned dance, fight, everything, after I became an actor. So that was a big blunder I did, but fortunate, blessed. There's definitely one hand blessing on my head. Yeah.
Jyothika, what were you saying?
I was just saying we have a blend of both, actually, in the South. We have had a lot of actors also who've come in, new, and both actors, children and the outsiders, both have been accepted equally. And there is a lot of new talent coming in. 2D itself makes films without us. You know, we are having people who we are introducing new. So I think it's a blend. And even for actors, children, I think they are also have to timelessly prove themselves or live up to the expectation of their parents. So it's either ways, it's tough on both the sides also.
Yeah.
It's a good blend in the South. We also have a lot of new people who've come in who are fantastic.
Respect and value for people who have not had parents or relatives from the film industry and who are successful. Yeah. And we have a lot of respect for what they have been able to achieve. Yeah. A lot of respect for that.
For me, Surarai Potru was, of course, a very, very inspiring underdog story, but it was also one of the most romantic scenes, films I've seen in a long time. And that marriage proposal scene in the auto was just outstanding. And of course, it was written for you, Surya, but I have to ask Jyothika, is he anything like that in life?
Yeah, he's very romantic. He's a great person. I mean, it's not just me saying that. If you ask anybody here in the state, he is. They will all say, I feel it largely works because of a man. The women are always good. So a marriage, you agree. The marriage largely
works.
Why
are you asking them?
It largely works if the man is good. And, the very fact that, he gives me that equal space, I get to choose my film, the banners with both of us in it. And it speaks volumes about him. I mean, there's less said by me also speaks it all.
We try to be perfect. There are a lot of imperfections. We try to be perfect. We always, yeah.
The person. Okay, what can you tell me about the Hindi remake of Surarai? Are you a part of it?
We are a part of it. We want
specifically, are you a part of it?
As producers, yes.
Okay, those are big shoes to fill. Who is doing your part is what I want to know.
Very soon you'll be getting the news. The big one.
So you're definitely not doing the crossover to Hindi cinema.
I really love, would want to do something like that, but I genuinely tried to learn another language.
No, he didn't try to learn it. He's married. We're married now for 15 years and he's not tried learning Hindi at all.
I don't know.
Hindi
is very tough for me. I'm not able to.
She's learned Tamil. Come on.
In the class, there can be an average student, a poor student and a first class student, like the first rank holders, right? So what?
what I find really lovely is how you are always appreciating Jyothika so much professionally. You talk about her as an actor. You talk about her sincerity. You talked about how she is a more sincere actor than you are. You appreciate the professional that she is, which is very rare. I mean, I don't see a lot of sort of major male stars doing that. Now, you both have been married for, I think, 15 years it is. You did 7 films together. Has your relationship changed much, or are you still those two people who met way back in the day and fell in love?
I think we fight more and get closer more, I think. We've gotten more closer. And
yeah,
definitely.
We've only gotten closer, actually. And the first reason, of course, like in any married couple, is that being the kids. And we've been more of friends than a couple, actually. So we love having our morning coffees together. If one leaves earlier than the other for work, then we've missed our morning coffee time also. We don't forget to send an SMS saying missing you at the coffee, you know. So it's we are more, you know, we have similar interests. We both like going for outdoor jogs. We both, you know, are in the same production house producing films. We both are actors. So there's so much to talk. Except the kitchen part.
You don't need a magnifying glass to know what she is doing. I think anybody, you just have, okay. No, to someone to leave Mumbai, Bandra, and to come to Chennai and to learn this language and to master it and to do such films and to, you know, take all the cake. And even in our films, she takes all the spotlight. Most of the films she's been...
I know that is not...
No, I'm just telling, because I don't think I can do that. Travel to another state, learn that language, and make that position for yourself. Writers, directors, they still come to her directly, having her image in mind and what she has achieved. The writers are able to write stories for her, believe that she can deliver. There are 4 or 5 ideas which are fantastic, and they still believe Jyothika can be that character, can do that. And it's an open book that she's superlative and she's more talented than me, but she chooses to sit at home and take care of both kids. And I'm able to go out and I'm able to do films and, you know, come back home. And her 4 or 5 projects.
My God,
he's
going to get so many more female fan following now, which is more of a stress for me now.
So I only have to be thankful and
That is so sweet. Okay, I'm going to end with asking you, what do you want people to take away from Jai Bhim? You know, what would be for you that thing that they should keep in their hearts as they exit the theater?
We can be selfless. You don't have to always think about you, your immediate family, friend circle, and live only that life. Sometimes if there is something which you can do to help another person, and it goes a long way, and it might be a huge change in their life. And if you watch this film, that's what it will say. The character name is Sengeni, and everybody, everywhere, there was silence around her. And where that silence took her, what it led to, will be said in the story. And what if one man is able to lend his voice and stand for this girl, and what a big change he can bring in. And to be that strong change maker is not going to be easy. To stand by the truth, to stand for that fight is not going to be easy, but it must be done. Sometime, once in a while, once in your life.
Go out on that limb.
I think this film will inspire, and you don't have to always make people invisible. You have seen these people around you, and have you bothered to know about their life and what they're going through? Be very, very conveniently choose to see them as invisible people, and we see through them. So what are they going through, and how we can be a part of this change, and be a little more at least concerned about them, and how a legal system, it's just not, we have a lot of laws, and we have a police department, we have a lot of other things, but how one person is able to use his skill, and for whom you use that skill, how this law is used to bring in a beautiful change. It's just not because of law and the police department, everything's functioning smoothly. It's about people who come in between and use it in a certain way. It makes life more beautiful. So nice. There's a lot of talk about Chandru sir, and this is just one case, one true incident which happened in 1995. But there are a lot of other beautiful things which he's also said. So you wanted to tell the case of Sengeni, which happened for real, and also celebrate Chandru sir, who's been among us in the society, and how a lot of unsung heroes should be thanked, appreciated, celebrated.
Cannot wait to see it. Thank you, Jyotika and Surya, and good luck for Jai Bhim.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Ankur.